What's up, guys? It's the third, and today we're going to be playing a game that is really close to my heart because this is the first game I ever played. This is the one that started it all. It's Halloween. I love that intro. Everyone's playing a scary game of some sort, and I'm going to play one too. And that game is going to be Zombies Ate My Neighbors, a game made in 1993 by LucasArts and by Konami. Really awesome game. Really fun game. This is a gem. This right here is a gem. Tons of people believe this is one of the best games of the 90s, if not the best game on the system of Genesis and SNES, you know, besides Mario and things. So this is a really fun game. It's up to two players, but we're going to be playing by myself today because it's better that way anyway, because you have to share items and it's just a mess. Anyway, really fun game, really simple concept, but when you put it into action, this game can get insanely hard. It's ridiculous at times, and it's just, it can make you rage. Anyway, so like I said, this is the first game I ever played, when I was 4 or 3 years old. My sister was playing this with me. So there's a lot of feels when it comes to this game because, the whole concept basically is to get these neighbors, right? These little babies. Oh my god, I got a bazooka. Oh my, guys, holy shit. Wait, hold on, stop, pause. Okay. Okay, I'm not even gonna lie right now. I was gonna stop this recording, like, right before I got to that cupboard right there. And I was gonna pause and keep restarting over and over again until I got a bazooka. Because I want you guys to see the secret level that you can't get to unless you get that particular bazooka that I just got, which you only have a 1.7% chance of getting. So, holy fuck. Did that really just happen? Oh my god. Okay. Anyway, like I said, the whole concept is to get these neighbors, and you cannot let these enemies, like these zombies here and other enemies, touch them. If you let them touch them, they will die. Some characters have more HP than other ones, but most of them only have, you know, one hit and they're dead kind of thing. But if you let one of your neighbors die, then that means that you'll start off the next level with however many were alive. So basically, if I let 3 die this level, I only have 7 to save in the next level. And the whole bad part about that is, if you get down to one neighbor and that one neighbor dies, that means you get a game over. And it's not good to get a game over, because there's a lot of levels in this game. I just cannot believe I got a bazooka. Like, that... If you guys have played this game before, you know how freaking rare that is. Like, that's not even me editing or anything. That just happened. Like, what the heck? Oh my god, I just got a freaking bazooka. Anyway, behind those little fences, I got 2 health packs, which are very vital in this game. No pun intended. Here's the secret, by the way. I just cannot believe I got this. I literally am astounded that I got this. Oh my god. Health packs are very useful in this game because basically you only have about, I think that's 10 bars worth of damage you can take, worth of health. If you die, you die. So when you get down to 1 bar, that's usually when you use your health pack. And wow, I'm still really surprised I got a bazooka. Like, that's so unlikely, it's not even funny. Okay, so we beat level 1, pretty easy and pretty, astounding. Absolutely astounding. Wow. Okay, so this next level is absolutely ridiculous. It's called Day of the Tentacle, and the reason why it's ridiculous is because these things respawn in the worst fucking place on the fucking map. Like, they respawn directly on top of neighbors sometimes, and it's stupid. It's the dumbest thing I've ever seen. It's just like, why did you make this game so hard? Anyway, so we need to do this, what I'm doing right now, so I can get this baby without it dying. And I need to do this one more time, because there is 2 soldiers to my right. And I can't get them, because they'll get wrecked. Well, okay, there's a chance they won't be, but there's also a chance that they'll respawn at the wrong place, and then he'll die. And I don't want to take that chance, you know? So that's why I'm doing this. Okay. Alright, this is fine, this is good, 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 this is good. Okay. Mine and mine. Okay. You guys see why I did that? Like, yeah, I did that because if I didn't, they probably would have died. And like I said, you don't want your neighbors to die. If you guys have played this game before, and you're just rewatching it because, well, you're a good subscriber, and because, oh, this brings back memories, you can actually do what I just did just now in order to prevent certain neighbors from turning into certain enemies. Ooh, and I think you know what you're talking about, or what I'm talking about. But we're not going to spoil anything for those who haven't played it. So. Okay, let's go through here, and there is a this, and we need that, and we need to go around. There's another point in the level where they respawn in dumb locations, but we'll get there when we get there. Alright, so let's just get this key, and then we'll get this. Alright, you see that? See? You see that? Do you see that? Do you see that thing trying to get that girl? If that wall was like... wasn't there, or like if he wasn't a character that can't die, because I don't believe the trampoline girls can die, shoot him dead. And that's how the look, see it? There's three of them. Four. It's about four of them trying to ambush her right now. Stupid, right? It's at five. Just get rid of all of them. Yeah. Anyway. So let's go over here, and we'll go ahead and get this guy. These guys are very safe for the beginning half of the game, but as time goes on, of course. Something will happen to them too. But what will that be? Find out on the next, what, 4 or 5 episodes, I think? We'll get to that level. Of zombies and my neighbors. Get him. Oh my god. Get out of the way. I don't even know one could respond there. Are you real? Okay. Oh, I need this. Skeleton key. Rarest item in the game. Don't forget about that. If you see a skeleton key, click the screen. Tell me about it. Alright. Let's get, oh my god. Do you know how rare this is? I'm getting all these rare things! Rare! Absolutely rare! What the fuck? Okay, that's fine. Oh my god! I just got a health pack! I got a bazooka and a health pack on fucking the first two levels. It's gonna be a good LP, I already know. Okay, let's go ahead and avoid you. Okay, well, not avoid, because I need him. I need you. Okay. Or there's actually an easier way to do this I can think of. We basically need to be the trampoline girl. So, basically, here's what we need to do. Go over here, jump on this. And I need more to appear. So this is 1, 2, 3? Okay. I need more! Oh my god, I need more. Like, I need 1, 2, good, 3. What? Okay, 1, 2, 3. 3, come with me, okay. Okay, 4. Okay. Okay. Get into that sprite, okay, get into that area where everyone else is. Overlap each other, please. That'd be nice. Alright, good. No, don't do that! Fuck! Oh, bitch. Don't- Oh, over there! Oh, this is like fucking trying to handle sheep. Are you real? Okay, good. Okay, yes? Alright, good. Yes? Okay. Okay, we're good. Come with me. No, come here! Okay. Come the fuck here! Come- Okay. Okay. Well, he can just go. Okay. Come with me! If you don't fucking come with me... Okay, I gotta get this teacher. Okay, now we can do this. Okay, come over here. There we go. Okay! Ooh! Fuck! That was just unnecessarily, just unnecessary. Okay, we needed to do that because if we didn't, then that hamburger guy would have died. Would have died. Yeah, that's the word. Would have died, and we don't want that to happen. We got 4 freaking health packs. Oh my god. On level 2. Wow. What are we getting here? Hopefully we get something good. Yes, maybe. Well, okay. If I get something rare here, expect me to go belligerent, okay? Ah. Wow, that was fun. This is a secret level, like I said. So that means we'll never be able to come back to this level, or we won't see anything like it. Who is it, that loud-ass motorcycle outside me? Okay, whatever. Let's go ahead and go on to the next level. That was a really good run for the X level. Usually, at least one person dies, but they didn't, so we did good. Okay. Evening of the Undead. Evening of the Undead. Great level. As you can see, they respawn in dumb locations. That's one of the things that make this game hard. They respawn in the worst locations possible. The worst ones. Okay, there is a hamburger guy up here. There is a teacher in danger. And there's a baby in danger, and there's an explorer in danger. Don't get hit. Don't. If you touch that fucking baby. Okay. I got all three of them safely. Gosh. Oh my god. Don't you dare. Okay. Oh my fucking goodness. This game. Stop. Okay. Will we hear anything good? Ooh, a key. Yes. What's in here? Ooh, soda cans, good. Ooh, another key. What's in here? Okay, nothing. Good. Oh, that was a good bounty. Oh my gosh. Okay. Alright. We will go ahead. Get out of my fucking... Okay. So as you can see, I could have went through that door right here, but I would have been wasting a key because I just go around to the open door. Good. Let's get her, because you can actually just leave her, and she's gonna be completely safe because nobody can get her. I know I'm gonna get wrecked here, but... A ghost potion! Oh my god! I'm getting all these rare things! I'm telling you guys, these things only have like a freaking 3, 2, 1.7, like, percent chances of happening, and I'm getting them. That's so rare. Gosh. Anyway, so there's secrets, which is that one. There's a secret potion in there. Go over here. And there's an explorer. And another trash can we can possibly get something in. It's funny, I'm just thinking about it. It's just like, who throws a potion in the trash can, you know? Let's see what we get here. Hopefully we get something good. Get out of my way. I shouldn't be losing health to freaking zombies. Whatever. So if you go over here, there's one more secret, and that's more decoys. Yeah. Yas. And there's one more thing that we need to get before we leave, and that is get out of my way. Okay, down here to the right. You! And we need this key. And we need this. Okay, we are good. Next level, which is the next level of which we will stop at, is my favorite level. Well, not my favorite level, but is one of my favorite levels, especially in the beginning. Anything over here? Let me just check. Nope, just death. Okay. Go in this door, and there we go. Okay. One of my favorite levels is this one. Terror in Aisle 5. This level is one of my favorite levels. I love it. Get you, get you, get you. There are tourists over here, of which we have to go get immediately. There we go. Ouch. Okay, really? Alright, get the cheerleader. Next thing we need is... the fire extinguisher. It's gonna be really useful. Next thing we gotta do is actually not go through that door, because it's wasting. Go around here to the open side and get this. Alright. That cheerleader there is actually completely safe. There's no enemies that can respawn into any of that location. I guess you could, I don't know, trace a zombie over there, but I don't know why anyone would ever want to do that. So there's a key, and I think there's popsicles over here to the right, or left. Popsicles? Popsicles? Yep, yes. There you go. Really useful item. Why? You'll see. So let's get you and the secret potion. I think we have like, what, 3 or 4 right now? Wow. Soda. I think sometimes if you break open the soda machines, they actually have sodas in them. But they are rare, and it's usually not worth it. So, go around here, and go down here, and there are oh my god, no. Nope, we're not gonna do that yet. Gotta go over here, gotta go over here, gotta go over here. Don't you fucking dare. Okay. Oh. Okay, oh my god, okay, I'm just a little paranoid, because usually they die over here. Okay. Alright, now that we've gotten all the neighbors, which is that is top priority, is to get the neighbors, because the items just sit there. So now what we gotta do is get all the items that we have left behind, which include some decoys. Oh my god, get away from me. Some tomatoes. Really useful item. Oh my god, tomatoes are so good. Because they go through walls. You wanna know what I mean? Ooh, that is an aggressive zombie. Oh my god. Wow, aggressive zombie. Holy crap. I'll tell you guys when aggressive zombie. Okay, you see how that zombie is just, you know, aimlessly walking around? Well. Okay, when I say aimlessly, you see how he's just walking like that? An aggressive zombie, which I think we have one right now, is. Okay, I'll let you know when you see one. There's one. Okay, you see that one to the bottom of me? See how it's like not even close to me and yet it's trailing me? That's an aggressive zombie. You can't tell the difference between the two, but you can tell from the movement patterns they have. Anyway, gotta open this, and there is going to be a health pack in there that you can see, and there's also one more over here. Get out of my way, get out of my way, get out of my way. That's why I don't play Black Ops. Oops, and go ahead and get this. Okay. I think that's it. Nothing over here besides aggressive zombies. Like, they respawn there. Like, over here is all aggressive zombies. See? All of them. All of them. Aggressive. So I'm gonna go over there. Anyway, this is the reason why tomatoes are good. For those of you who were trying to get what I was saying, but I didn't say it. They go through walls. See this? Go through this wall. See? Like that. Oh, you guys are weak to tomatoes? You're weak to tomatoes! Oh, and they sometimes turn into that. And they will wreck you. But, you know, if you have your fire extinguisher, all you gotta do is just, can I do it? There we go. And they just die. Alright, well, we have beaten this level, and I think we will stop after this, because it's been quite a while. So this has been Episode 3rd. Let's go ahead and go through this door, and, next time we'll go to the level. The level. If you guys have played this game before, you know what level I'm talking about. The level. Yeah. Anyways, that's been Episode 3rd. Thank you guys so much for watching. Be sure to stay tuned for more Zombies at My Neighbors. And we got a life! Wow! Subscribe for more. Leave a like rating later on. So I'll see you guys later. Have a great day, and bye.